Welcome back.
We arrived before the Borg. Now my heart can start beating again. What are your orders, Captain? Tavrell managed to establish a comm link with Willa Post, the administrator of Vega Colony. It's not a great signal, but it's the best we're gonna get. Putting her through now.
Greetings, Captain. Is there something I can do for you today? Repeat, please. Your signal is breaking up. Did you say the Borg? What about them?
I have lost contact with Vega Colony, sir. Something is blocking all subspace signals in this area. Even our hails to the civilian ships are not getting through. There is a communication satellite nearby. It should boost our signal sufficiently to inform the freighters of the danger and warn the colony.
I want my own Spock. I realize that now. And I think what's happening here is that Flores is, you know, like the equivalent of Spock. And Travell is the black girl that I can't think of her name right now.
Our hails are still blocked, sir. The Borg may be attempting to isolate the planet before they land. Your orders, sir.
Borg are jamming up any remote signals. It's not safe to beam through that. I think I can boost the gain, though.
Transwarp conduits opening all over the system, Captain. The Borg are here.
Of course they are. Of course they are.
Those civilian ships are right in the Borg's path. We have to help them.
Okay, see? That sounds like an order to me. And she shouldn't be giving me orders. That was not a suggestion. That was an order. This is why that girl ticks me off. I don't know. She does. So, what I need is my own Spock. Because Spock would not give that type of response. Spock would have said, the civilian ships are encountering the Borg. And then that's it. I mean, he would not get the emotional reaction. That's where I have an issue. I don't like overly emotional people, I guess. I mean, it's great to feel and whatnot, but I'm the captain. She shouldn't be giving me orders. It should be the other way around. So I don't think I can make Travell my number one, you know, the person under me, because I don't think she's got the right path for that. She seems to be more like the black girl on the original Star Trek, and Travell holds Spock's position. I'm not satisfied with that right now. I wasn't satisfied with Tuvan, because do not give me orders. Tell me what is happening and allow me to make an informed decision on what needs to be done. So my first goal is to get a Spock as my number one.
Captain, I have short-range communications. Long-range signals are still blocked. I can contact the planet and have informed Administrator Post of the situation. However, the Borg have already landed and are moving toward the colony. It may be more prudent to retreat back to the Renown, sir.
See how she phrased that? It may be more prudent.
Borg landing craft detected nearby. Captain, there are civilian ships engaging them.
I believe I can send a message to those ships.
Not we have to do such and such. You see the difference there? You see the difference? Yeah.
Civilian ships, you are ordered to disengage and retreat. We will cover you.
And of course, the problem is going to be that I can't do that. Because Flores's voice is all through here, probably all the way up through the levels, and I probably can't just switch that out like that, because that would have been very expensive to be able to switch people around to do all of that voice acting. So I'm somehow going to have to deal, I guess. But there's one point that I wanted to bring up that I was thinking about as I was playing through this. The Borg was one of my favorite enemies, being assimilated by the Borg. I like that enemy for some reason or another. But that's very similar to what we're experiencing now, like, for example, with zombies. You know, turning into a zombie. So back then, the Borg was the hot geeky shit, and now zombies are the hot geeky shit. And it makes you wonder, you know, if your loved ones were threatened by the Borg, what would you do? I mean, these are the same situations we face
Captain,
with the, like,
the
playing
have landed,
Walking
and
Dead.
And the colony won't be able to hold them off for long. I recommend beaming down to Vega and getting as many people out as we can. Captain, according to our readings, over half the planet is already assimilated by the Borg. At the rate they're progressing, the region we're in will be overrun in roughly 1 hour. And if that wasn't bad enough, the interference is affecting the ship's transporters. No, sir. I'll follow your lead.
Well, that's surprising. She's gonna follow my lead. So, yeah, I was thinking about that. The storylines, a lot of these storylines really aren't new to us, are they, that we're experiencing today? They're things that we've seen before in a different format. You know, it made me wonder about that because, okay, when I first encountered the Borg storylines, you know, that was like a really creepy, scary kind of, what the hell are you doing? That was really a creepy, scary kind of concept that a machine could take over your body, okay? And then you go off, you know, with them to be part of the collective. Imagine, you know, if the Borg invaded your city. Because this is, like I said, what we're dealing with all the zombie games coming out and all the zombie series coming out. The Borg were to come to your city and...
We are the Borg. Resistance is futile.
The Borg are activating the transport...
You know, they want to take over. What do you do?
We need to disable that force...
Would you... There she goes, giving orders again. Daggone it! Ugh! if you found that your spouse, your parents, your loved ones, your enemies, your coworkers, you know, were in threat to being taken over by the Borg, what would you do? Would you run? Would you try to save them? Even with your enemies, would you really want them to be part of the Borg? You know, would you try to save them? So that's something that I was thinking about. And, you know, in Walking Dead, I made some very tough choices. That really weren't tough. It's like, okay, this is a harsh environment that we're in. If I can't save you, it's better and actually more merciful.
The ship is transporting anyone they can get a lock on, Captain, but we don't have much time. We need to get back as soon as possible.
I love this. It just doesn't get old. It's actually more merciful to kill them. Although it may seem cold, it's actually, you know, in their best interest and for the safety of others. So, would you be able to do it? Now, oh, great. Help. Thank you. Back when I first encountered the Borg, you know, it was sort of, oh my god, you have to save everybody.
Let us finish this.
Now it's like, I'm tougher, and I would actually be able to make, you know, some of those decisions that I wouldn't have been able to make back then. And one of the things that I love about playing this game is because it's based on a series that's been around so long, you can actually look back and think back at what you were doing, what were you thinking, you know, what your thoughts were back when it was on TV, and compare them to now and see how far you've come. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, I can definitely see differences in how I would react to things. Like, I don't think Flores giving those orders would have bothered me back then. But now, noise the hell out of me because out of place. She shouldn't be giving me orders. It should be the other way around, I think. I mean, maybe, does the order barking bother you? Do you guys playing? Does it bother you?
We held off what we could in Pollux and sent a signal out to Starfleet. These were the closest ships. Others will be arriving as soon as they can. You have handled things well thus far. Excellent thinking on reconfiguring the satellites into warning beacons. We received the signal as soon as we arrived in the system.
Thank you.
I will be discussing that option with the other captains here, but your priority is to protect the civilians you have on board, as well as to ensure the safety of your crew. The Kittimer will return to Earth space dock with you. Once you arrive, report to Admiral Quinn. He will have more information for you. You and your crew have done well. Golez would make a fine addition to your senior staff.
Awesome. We get a new person. Okay, that's it for this one.
Captain
Thank you
Bullock
for
told us to get to Earth space dock, and I think he's right. We need to get the civilians to safety, and I don't think I can handle any more excitement.
Did I ask you? Oh my god. Thank you for watching. If you like the video, hit the thumbs up button. It lets me know if you like the video or not. Thank you for liking and sharing the videos and interacting with me. It allows me to do what I love, and I would not be able to do it without you. Links are in the description below, and I will see you guys in the next one.